Hello and the greetings from Iceland. I think it's safe to say that things have never before been as tense as now, since the next event is already overdue with 17 million cubic meters of magma ready to take off from a pressurising magma chamber. And the staff in the power plant by the Blue Lagoon, they didn't come to work today due to pressure changes in the geothermal boreholes that have so far been the best tool to predict the next eruptions. And it wasn't a problem to evacuate the power plant since it can be remotely controlled. But the Blue Lagoon remains open. And as we moved further into the day, this looks more and more like a false alarm. And lucky me, since I just got back yesterday from my second volcano tour from North Iceland to capture eruption outbreak. So I drove in total around 1500 kilometers on all sorts of roads, where I was filming, of course, but never far away from the most likely eruption site. So I have already invested over 20 days of my life to capture the beginning of the next eruption, mainly because it's the only type of footage that I need for my photo stock, since now I'm planning to make the first 8 eruptions into a larger project, covering this from day one in 2020. And so far, the eruption that we have been expecting has only left us with more and more uncertainty. The seismic activity has been moving further west than usual, but it's still unclear if the location of the next eruption will be a surprise. And to be honest, every day without an eruption makes me more uneasy about this whole scenario. Or as for the damages that a larger eruption than we have seen so far would cause. And as for this uncertainty when it comes to the timing, it's just impossible to predict anything right now. Or as Professor Sean Wilsey told me this morning, could be minutes, could be days, and that's just how things are. We are midst in a scenario that we have never witnessed before, but scientists are however getting lots of data, and that is highly important. And like we had planned, I met with Professor Sean by the Blue Lagoon a few days ago, but he was stuck with students. So we plan to meet again here in the north tomorrow, where he will do an interview with me, or if I'm not already back south tonight, but only if the eruption starts. But I do however fear that it will be bad news awaiting me on the peninsula, or even more damage by the town or the Blue Lagoon. The lava barriers, they can only handle a small eruption, we know that. And I had this strange feeling while I was filming in Grindavik and around the town, that this might be my last video set from this landscape. And during my stay, where I slept in my car for 3 days, I sometimes got a bad feeling about staying there, but kept myself busy all the time, not just filming, I was also improving my plan B, or to try all the trails that can get me into good drone range, in case I won't be in the evacuation zone when this starts. And after those 3 days on the peninsula, I drove back to Reykjavik and spent one night there. But I'm kind of hopeless without my desk. And it was indeed frustrating to drive north without the main goal from the trip unfulfilled for the second time. But I did come back with a travel story that I plan to tell you soon. And I'm quite pleased with the videos I captured this time. So after I upload this, I will keep on monitoring the situation. I didn't fully unload the car, and I will be going to the petrol station later today, fill it up to be ready, but I would also like to have a few days of rest, since this trip was very demanding, and I can use a few days in front of the computer. But as things look right now, I'm not sure. And Professor Magnus Tumi Gumundsson, he was saying just now that the eruption is just about to come up. We usually don't hear him say anything until things take off, sometimes even later. Nothing to see here, please. So I might do a fast edit on this one, throw my stuff into the car and hit the road, but then it's just impossible to predict anything. And if I don't see anything interesting on the seismometers tonight, I am going to stay for a while longer. And I'm leaving a link to my Instagram page that I have never promoted and hardly ever used. But I think it's a good idea for the travel story to fill up some of the gaps between my video uploads, so if I will drive back to Reykjavik soon, you can check on me there. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.